Start adopting this habit of daily practicing. You will be far ahead from where you are. So let's get started to solve the problem on the screen from curve fitting. So we have to fit a polynomial of second degree to the data points given in the following table. So x and y are given. So in order to fit a polynomial of second degree, so the required equation is y is equal to a naught plus a1 into x, a2 into x square. In order to find the value of a naught, a1 and an, so we have certain normal equations as, see here, this is sigma y is equal to n into a naught plus this is a1 into sigma x, this is a2 into sigma x square. Now we have to multiply with x. This is xy is equal to a naught into sigma x. This is a1 into sigma x square. This is a2 into sigma x cube. And if I multiply with x, this will be sigma x square y is equal to a naught into sigma x square. This is a1 into sigma x cube plus a2 into sigma x power 4. These are the three equations. So using these equations, we have to calculate a0, a1 and a2 and substitute in this equation. For that, we have to find sigma x, sigma x square, sigma x cube, sigma x power 4, sigma xy and sigma x square y. For that, there is a table here. See, you can see all the values here. So the x values are 0, 1, 2. So I am substituting that. This is 0, this is 1 and this is 2. And what are the y values? This is 1, 6 and 17. So y value is 1, 6 and 17. Now we have to square up all the x values. So 0 square is 0, 1 square is 1 and 2 square, this is 4. And the next one, x cube. 0 cube is 0 and 1 cube is 1 and 2 cube is 8. Power 4. 0 power 4, this is 1 power 4 and this is 2 power 4, which is equal to 16. And xy values. So you have to multiply this 2. 0 into 1 is 0, 1 into 6 is 6 and 2 into 17, this is 34. And later x square y. So you have to multiply x square with y. So that is 1 into 0 is 0, 6 into 1 is 6. And this is 17 into 4, this is 68. So after that, we have to add up all the values. So for adding all the values, you can use calci. That is, the total is 3 here. And the total is sigma y is 24. And sigma x square value is 5. And sigma x cube value is 9. And sigma x power 4 value is 17. And sigma xy value, this is 40 and sigma x square y is 74. So these are all the values after calculating, and we have to make a note of all these values and substitute in the normal equation so that we will get the values of a0, a1 and a2. So we have the values of sigma x as 3, this is sigma y as 24, this is sigma x square value as 5, and sigma x cube value is 9 and sigma x power 4 value is 17 and this sigma xy value is 40 and sigma x square y is 74. So now we have to substitute all these equations in the normal equations, that is sigma y is equal to n into a naught plus a1 into sigma x plus this is a2 into sigma x square. Now if I multiply with x, this will be sigma xy is equal to a0 into sigma x plus a1 into, this is a sigma x square, this is a2 into sigma x cube, and this is x square y is equal to, this x square y is equal to a0 into sigma x square, this is a1 into sigma x cube plus a2 into sigma x power 4. So in these equations, if I substitute, see what will happen. From this side, I'll n. What is n value? So n is nothing but 1, 2 and 3. So n is equal to 3 here. So we have the n value as 3. Now if I substitute if I substitute here, n value is 3, that is 3 into a naught. This is a naught plus sigma x. What is sigma x? This is 3. This is 3 into a1 plus sigma x square is 5. This is 5 a2 is equal to sigma y. What is sigma y here? This is 24. And here a naught into sigma x. Sigma x is 3. This is 3 a naught plus sigma x square value is 5. This is 5 a1 plus and sigma x cube. What is sigma x cube here? This is 9. So this is 9 into a2 is equal to sigma xy. So what is this value? This is 40. And later sigma x square, this is 5, this is 5, this is 5 a naught plus sigma x cube, this is 9, this is 9 a1 plus sigma x cube, this x power 4, this is a 17, that is a 17 a2 is equal to sigma x square y, which is equal to, this is a 74. So we have to solve all these three equations and we have to get the values of a0, a1 and a2 and substitute in the required equation. For that I am using this CalC, so it's very easy to operate. So there are three equations, so you have to go to mode and you have to press like that until you get an equation. So one I have to press. So how many unknowns are there? There are three unknowns, that is a0, a1 and a2. So now I'm pressing 3. So what is our a1 value? See, our a1 value is 3. See, I'm showing this a1 value is 3 and the next b1 value is also 3 and c1 value is 5 and next d1 value is 24 and later a2 value is 3 and b2 value is 5 and c2 value is 9 and later d2 value is 40. Next a3 value is 5, b3 value is 9 and this one is 17 and the last is 74. So I got the value of x as 1. See our x value. So our x value is 1 and later our y value is 2 and later our z value is 3. So using CalC, so what is our notation? So in place of x, it is a0, this is a1 and this is a2. Therefore, to fit a parabola, so this is polynomial. To fit a polynomial of second degree, the required equation is CR. The required equation y is equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2 into x square. So our required equation y is equal to what is a0? This is 1 plus 2 into x plus 3 into x square. So this is the answer and this is how we have to solve, and I hope you all felt easy. So using CalC also you can solve. And thank you for watching. I want you to practice and benefit by these videos. I'll keep bringing up these videos for you and stay connected. Who couldn't like your subscription? Please subscribe to this channel before you leave. Thank you so much.